There are more than 500 species of sharks swimming in the world's oceans, ranging in size from the tiny 8-inch-long dwarf lantern shark to the more than 39-foot-long whale shark. Sharks are found in just about every kind of ocean habitat, including the deep sea, the open ocean, coral reefs, and under the Arctic ice. A small number even inhabit freshwater. Sharks come in a variety of colors. Some species are solitary, while others hang out in groups. Lemon sharks, for example, have been found to congregate in groups to socialize. Most sharks have two dorsal fins on top, with the first typically larger than the second. Sharks play an important role in ocean ecosystems, especially the larger species. Larger sharks hunt as top predators and keep ecosystems in balance. Their disappearance can have ripple effects throughout an entire ecosystem. Instead of bones, sharks have skeletons made of cartilage. Cartilage is a hard but flexible material that makes up human noses and ears. Cartilage is much lighter than bone. This helps sharks to stay afloat and swim long distances while using less energy. Heavier than water, sharks sink if they stop swimming. Unlike bony fish, which maintain their position in the water column with the help of a gas-filled organ called a swim bladder, sharks do not have swim bladders. Instead, they have a very large liver full of oil that helps with buoyancy. The oily liver allows them to rise or descend in the water column more rapidly than fish with swim bladders. Oil is incompressible and provides constant buoyancy regardless of depth and pressure. Most sharks primarily feed at night. Typically, sharks like to eat animals ranging from crustaceans, like crabs, to squid, fish, and marine mammals like seals and sea lions. On the rare occasions that sharks bite humans, it's typically out of curiosity, to defend themselves from a perceived threat, or because they've confused a human for an animal they typically prey on. Many sharks have developed specific mechanisms that help them capture their prey. Some bottom-dwelling sharks like wobbegongs, also called carpet sharks, hide and ambush their prey, sucking them into their mouth. The thresher shark has a long, tapered tail that it slaps into a school of fish to stun them and grab its meal. There are also some large species of sharks that are filter feeders. The basking shark, megamouth shark, and whale shark all consume zooplankton and small fish. They have modifications on their gills, called gill rakers, that act to strain the small organisms so they can swallow prey in large gulps. Every shark has several rows of teeth. However, not all shark teeth are the same. Some are needle-like, ideal for grabbing fish out of the water. Some are razor-sharp for biting off chunks of prey, allowing the shark to attack and eat larger animals. Sharks that eat shellfish have flatter teeth for breaking shells. Meanwhile, filter-feeding sharks have very small teeth that aren't used for feeding. Sharks are constantly shedding their teeth and replacing them with new teeth. A single shark can lose and replace thousands of teeth in its lifetime. In order to breathe, most sharks have 5 gill slits on each side of their body, although some shark species have 6 or 7 gill slits. After water flows into a shark's mouth as it swims, the shark closes its mouth, forcing the water to move over the gills. The gills extract oxygen from the seawater. Then the water is expelled through the gill slits. Many shark species, especially those that frequently rest on the bottom, pump water over their gills to make sure the oxygen never stops flowing. This is called buccal pumping. Sharks like nurse sharks, angel sharks, and wobbegongs commonly use buccal pumping. Some sharks, like the big eye thresher shark, have large eyes, while other sharks, like the brown-banded bamboo shark, have very small eyes. Much like cats, sharks have a layer of mirrored crystal behind their retinas called the tapetum lucidum. This layer allows them to see better in dark and cloudy waters. For hearing, sharks have two small openings on their head that lead to internal ears. Sharks have unique skin that is made up of millions of small, V-shaped, placoid scales, also called dermal denticles. The rows of denticles are smooth in one direction, but in the opposite direction, they feel like sandpaper. The denticles allow water to flow smoothly past the skin, reducing friction and increasing swimming efficiency. The denticles also discourage barnacles and algae from growing on the shark. Speedy sharks also tend to have a slim, torpedo-shaped head. Sharks gain additional speed by stiffening their tail while swinging it back and forth. Thanks to these adaptations, some shark species, like the great white shark and the short-fin mako shark, are some of the fastest swimmers in the ocean. Sharks have excellent senses, including the ability to detect blood or the vibrations of thrashing and wounded animals over long distances. At close range, sharks have the ability to detect the small electrical fields that all animals create with movement, such as the heartbeat of an animal hidden in the sand. To do this, sharks have small mucus-filled pores on their head, collectively called ampullae, or ampullae, of Lorenzini. This ability assists them in catching prey. The ampullae of Lorenzini compose part of the shark's lateral line. The lateral line is a sensory organ that stretches down their sides from gills to tail. The long, hollow tube opens out into the skin at perforated scales. This system allows sharks to sense water displacement, pressure, and direction. Sharks also use electroreception to navigate. They can sense the Earth's electromagnetic field, which is likely what allows some species to migrate across large distances without getting lost. Some species migrate vast distances in order to find food or breed in certain areas. Several shark species migrate from deep water to shallow water and back every day. This is called dial vertical migration. For example, blue sharks spend their nights in the top 325 feet of the ocean, but will dive down to depths of 1,300 feet or more and back to the surface throughout the day. Shark lifespans are not well known and vary a lot among species. Large sharks have few natural predators, aside from other sharks. Sharks are killed by humans both intentionally and unintentionally as bycatch. Bycatch means that while the fishermen are trying to catch a different kind of fish, they accidentally catch sharks in their nets too. The sharks that live near the seafloor are especially susceptible to bottom trawling fisheries that drag a net across the ocean floor. An estimated 100 million sharks are killed by fisheries every year. They may be used for their meat, fins, liver oil, and skin. Fins are the most valuable part of the shark. Millions of sharks are caught each year for their fins, which are prized for shark fin soup. Some of the shark fins used to make this soup are cut off and sold at markets alongside the shark they came from, but many are cut off of live sharks, which are then thrown back into the ocean to drown in order to save space on board for the more valuable fins. Sharks grow and mature slowly and reproduce only a small number of young, making them highly susceptible to overfishing. Many shark species take a decade or more to reach maturity, and then only produce a small number of young every 1 to 2 years. All sharks reproduce through internal fertilization. A male shark has two claspers on the rear of his underside, which he inserts into a female shark to deliver sperm to her eggs. Males may use their teeth to hold on to females while mating. There are multiple different ways that a shark pup can be born, depending on the species. Viviparous shark species, like the hammerheads, maintain a placental link to the shark embryo, similar to humans, and give birth to live young. In aplacental viviparity, also called ovoviviparity, there is no placental link, but live birth is still given. Ovoviviparity is the most common type of reproduction in sharks. It occurs when the egg hatches while still inside the mother. Once hatched, the embryo gains nutrition from what remains of the egg yolk, nutritious fluids from the mother's body, and sometimes from consuming other eggs in the uterus. Sand tiger sharks will actually eat their siblings in the womb. Other shark species release an egg case where the developing embryo gains nutrients from a yolk. This is called oviparity. Typically, sharks that live on the seafloor, like the swell shark, are oviparous. They attach their egg case to a rock or other hard surface, or wedge it into a safe spot on a sandy bottom or rocky area. The egg case of most sharks is a leathery, transparent brown, with slits on either side that allow water to flow through to replenish oxygen into the sac. Once the nutrients from the yolk sac are used up, the small shark makes its way out of the case to fend for itself. The empty egg cases often wash up on beaches and are referred to as mermaid purses. All shark young are born fully formed, and they are able to hunt and feed. They must fend for themselves with no parental care after birth. Today, living sharks are grouped into several orders. The ground sharks order includes sharks like tiger sharks and hammerhead sharks. Most sharks are part of this order, even the few species that inhabit freshwater. The members are defined by an elongated snout and thin, tough inner eyelids called nictitating membranes that protect their eyes from damage when taking down prey. This order also includes the unique bull shark that is generally a marine species, but can tolerate freshwater and travel up and down rivers at will. The bullhead sharks order includes smaller sharks, reaching lengths of around 5 feet. They have a pig-like snout and small spines on their fins. They live on the shallow seafloor in warm and tropical areas of the Pacific and Indian Oceans. The cow sharks and frilled sharks order includes the most primitive sharks alive today, with skeletons resembling those of ancient, extinct sharks. These sharks have 6 or 7 gill slits, depending on the species. Frilled sharks can only survive in very deep water. The order of mackerel sharks includes sharks like the great white shark, megamouth shark, and thresher shark. Mackerel sharks are found all over the world, from shallow water to the deep sea. The order of carpet sharks is so called because many of these species have ornate carpet-like skin patterns. They include species like the whale shark, along with wobbegongs and bamboo sharks. The order of saw sharks includes bottom-dwelling sharks that are about 5 feet long, with saw-like snouts. After detecting their prey's vibrations in the water, they slash at them with their saws to disable or kill them. The order Squaliformes includes a wide variety of sharks, such as the spiny dogfish, the dwarf lantern shark, and the Greenland shark. Some of the sharks in this order possess luminous organs. The last order, the angel sharks, contains sharks that look a lot like skates, with flat bodies that they bury beneath the sand on the seafloor. They lie in wait for their prey of small fish and squid, and then surprise them with a deadly bite. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button